Good evening, Debbie, and we are going to talk about that rain forecast for tomorrow in just a second. I do want to show you what conditions are looking like if you're looking to get down to Tahoe this weekend. It's kind of a mess out there on I-80. Get ready for winter weather to really amp up over the next few hours in that region, so I would probably avoid getting on the roads heading down to Tahoe over the next day or so. Scattered showers lingering in our neck of the woods tonight. Tomorrow, mountain showers are the most likely. We'll see a slight chance for some valley showers in the afternoon and evening. It really doesn't look all that likely, though. And then we do dry out across all areas heading into Sunday. Now, we do have a winter weather advisory in effect from 4 a.m. on Sunday for portions of the Sierra down to around 6,500 feet. So this is going to be high elevation snow tonight. Snow levels dropping to around 4,000 feet tomorrow. So getting lower heading into your Saturday. And then we also have that winter weather advisory in a very small area of Modoc County through 4 a.m. tomorrow morning. Could see potential up there for some isolated areas of up to 15 inches of snowfall, but that's mainly down south of our neck of the woods. For our area, looks like maybe 5 to 10 inches of snowfall. Possible, not all that likely. 54 degrees for Chico right now. Winds a little breezy out of the southeast up to 22 miles an hour at the moment. 53 degrees in Redding with cloudy skies. Winds not as strong up to 12 miles an hour out of the south. And Bernie, calm winds with mid-40s right now. Not a bad evening in the mountains, but again, we are seeing that chance for more active weather moving through. And as you take a look at this all-encompassing map of Northern California, you can see it's just Chico seeing those really gusty conditions, less than 20 miles an hour elsewhere out of the south right now. Satellite and radar showing that active weather continuing throughout the day. It's kind of been a little bit of a lull since the morning hours, though, for the valley, and this stream of moisture continues tonight. Low pressure heading through to our north, a weaker system moving in tomorrow. It's not going to carry as much moisture with it. So here's a look at your hyperlocal futurecast. Debbie, you asked about tomorrow night in Oroville. Well, for tonight, it looks like we're going to see some scattered showers in the valley. Most of this is going to really diminish by tomorrow morning. Not much out there in the early morning hours. Towards the afternoon, a slight chance for some showers. Oroville not looking all that promising for the wet weather heading through. Higher elevations, that's where it looks like it's much more likely, and the north end of the valley as well. And then we do dry out heading into your Sunday forecast. Rain totals, not all that expected as you take a look through your weekend. Less than a quarter of an inch for the majority of the valley. Chico and Redding possibly being exceptions here. Oroville, I don't think we're going to see 0.3 of an inch. Higher elevations up to around a half an inch on the way. Snow totals not looking all that impressive either. Possibly 2 to 3 inches in some parts of our neck of the woods. Really not all that impressive. And then getting a look at your forecast tonight and tomorrow. Temperatures in the 20s to 30s overnight in the northern mountains, 30s to 40s for tomorrow afternoon. Rain and snow in the forecast tomorrow evening for the Sierra with temperatures topping out in the 30s to low 40s. Foothill areas in the low to mid 40s for most areas tomorrow, but Paradise up to 48 degrees with the chance for a few showers in the evening. For the valley overnight, scattered showers are still possible. Tomorrow it looks mostly dry with a chance for evening showers in mid 50s. Mid-valley areas in the mid 40s tonight, ending up in those mid to high 50s for tomorrow with a very slight chance for showers, around 20%. And you'll see that 20% chance of showers here in your 7-day forecast. We do dry out on Sunday through Tuesday, a slight chance for showers returning on Wednesday. Overnight lows getting much colder through the weekend, and then we do see another chance for showers returning as we head into the latter part of next week. But even that right now, a little iffy.
All right, thank you, Court. Time now for